All comfy, sitting by the fire.
Singing merry songs. Welcome, guys. We're back. The balance update is here. If you caught my video earlier in the week, I did talk about it. I got Boots here. Dragged you out of bed. It's not actually...
Yes, you did. You just said we were singing merry songs, though, and we haven't started singing merry songs. Well, we got to do that before this video starts.
You can do that on your own time, and I'll edit it in after the end slate. Do you know I quite...
You've got to be part of it, though.
No, we already sang on a video. I was singing that other song that other time. They don't want to hear that.
I'm sure
they want to hear our incredible observations and opinions about the upcoming balance.
the update to the update of the balance patch.
Yes, exactly. Or the preview to the balance patch. So if you missed it last weekend, oh man, we recorded a lot. I was pretty stressed that weekend, wasn't I, Boots? We were really
going
for it.
Oh, you were so stressed. You're like, I've only got 17 minutes to do this.
like
I know it's going to take 8 hours. So let's get this done.
So, I've only really had a look, but basically they've done an update to the global changes. That means even though this is a competitive patch, hopefully you guys are in the loop at this point. There are things that will affect everyone everywhere. We're going to open with that, and then we'll talk a bit about the world versus world stuff and the PvP stuff. This is based on the audience's feedback, what they're looking to change. And I've only glossed over the global stuff, so let's just start there, shall we, Boots? And see what we've got. So it's a post from Irenio over on the forums. He says, firstly, thanks for the feedback from the balance preview posts, and he links them. He says, sweet feedback, salty feedback, spicy feedback. It's all deeply appreciated as long as it's kept civil. We've got these additional changes for the upcoming update that will likely be in the late notes. So if you don't see them in the immediate release notes, these changes will still be there. Okay, so do you want to give us the first one there, Boots? Feel My Wrath?
Sure. We got new changes. Feel My Wrath, otherwise known as FMW, as we all know, was near the top of our list for adjustments for PvE, and your feedback pushed it to be unsplit from PvP and World vs. World now rather than later.
Right.
With balance update across all modes, Feel My Wrath will be 35-second cooldown, 5 seconds of quickness, and 10 seconds of fury.
So, we didn't talk about this. I do know what this situation is about, but we didn't talk about it in our video. Do you know? Do you want to fill in, or should I just
remember? I don't know, actually. Could you please tell me?
So, basically, the idea is in a lot of PvE at the moment, for like more high-end game stuff, people have realized you can just stack Guardians and have them spam the Elite. And that deals with all of your quickness issues. That's it. And so you really don't have to dedicate a slot there. Then you just put like a Renegade in that spams Alacrity on people. And you can play these really heavy DPS comps who cover those boons that previously we were using like a whole slot in the composition to deal with, right? So the game got super Guardian heavy, basically, because you could just take what was essentially nearly entirely just a DPS slot and put that Elite on it. And then there you go, quickness is solved for everyone. And so if that was like your bread and butter content, then it was kind of lame to see the massive slant towards Guardians. And that's why they're bringing the changes to PvE as well now, because they don't want, you know, that to be the situation. And a lot of people did talk about that when they did the update. We didn't, but I think it's a good move, really.
Yeah,
overall.
I think so too.
Next, they're talking about the stone flesh thing. As per the preview of Stoneflesh, we don't like that a minor trait gives you toughness and can make your elementalist a target in some of our content when that's not the goal of your build. We'll keep finding more places to adjust this, and the solution won't be the same in all places. We didn't have the opportunity to hit all of these cases, so if you see something missing because we can get it in this time, it's still on the list to adjust. So they're doing
so
it.
So hold
in
on
more.
A second. With Stoneflesh, what is it? What's the update to it? We don't like the minor trait gives you toughness.
It becomes vitality, remember? They've changed it so that when you swap to Earth Attunement, you'll get, and your Earth Specialized, you get vitality instead of toughness. Oh, no, it was percent reduction.
No, it wasn't. It was 7% damage reduction.
Yeah.
So, but what's the change now? Like, are they changing the change that they said?
No, they're saying they're adding more stuff to the list.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, they're adding more stuff. So the next thing is if you're using Weaver's Elemental Polyphony, so now you get Vitality. I'm pretty sure that's when you use the Elite, right? That's the Elite.
Mm-hmm.
And so now you get Vitality, not damage reduction. That's why I had Vitality in my mind, because they're doing Vitality
right
now. And I was going to complain about this. Firebrand as well, they have that minor, which is when they have quickness on them, they get Heal Power, Condi Damage, Toughness. It's now Heal Power, Condi Damage, Vitality.
Why aren't they also going percent-based
Exactly, exactly. That's what I'm wondering, because to be honest, Vitality is like better in some ways, particularly in like the competitive areas. I know we're in global right now, but like in terms of shrugging off condies and stuff like that, I actually like Vitality more. I really do.
I see what you're saying. I also like toughness though. It just, when it's not condi based, because of its nice synergy with healing power.
Yeah, exactly.
Especially for the Firebrand, that one trait that does give you healing power and toughness.
Together, yeah, and you can kind of double dip. Like, toughness is if you want to resustain a lot. Vitality is if you want kind of that wall against burst and against, you know, Condi and stuff. So, I don't know. I feel like they should have just done percent reduction still, but they've gone with Vitality there. There you have it. Mm. They say, as a side note to this specific type of change, it's not something we're changing if it's a major choice for this reason alone. If there are other reasons for changing traits, we'll look at it independently. Yeah, so it's just like minor stuff. It's like accidental stuff. I didn't really want to tech into this minor, and now it's got like this double ramification. That's what, and yeah. I agree with that. I think that's fine, right? And then they do list out some other stuff. So spiked armor over on warrior, thick skin, pack alpha. So that's, you know, beast mastery, ranger, merging with the soul beast, gets pack alpha.
It seems...
pack out,
yeah, it seems like they should really only change it, because the only reason they're changing it is because of the toughness tanking, right?
Yes.
So it seems like the only reason they should change anything, they shouldn't get rid of all toughness buffs from the game. They should just change the ones that might, like somebody who's doing a DPS role or a healing role might take.
I guess they could have that extra context. I don't agree, though, Boots, that they're getting rid of every toughness buff in the game.
Obviously they're not, because they didn't say they are.
Yeah, yeah, it's the minor ones, so it's not too bad. And then you got Death Magic's Armored Shroud. I'm pretty sure that's Death Magic. So, yeah, that's what they say. That's the global changes.
Okay, so the minor trait makes sense. Major trait, maybe not.
Yeah, I guess so. And people asked some other questions. Irenio did have another update down below, where he does talk about this topic. He says, on the plus vitality instead of toughness, the way that it works is your percentage of health at the time your vitality changes scales to the new maximum. For example, if you're at 100% health and you gain 100 vitality, you gain 1,000 health to fit the new max 1,000 you got. If you're 80%, you get 800 and so on and so on. So I think someone was asking about maybe cheesing it or something.
He also talks about the
obsidian flesh.
Feel my wrath changes later down too, it seems.
Yeah, regarding obsidian flesh, this is something on our list to look at to address in a different way in the not too distant future. We've got a few ideas, but there isn't time to prototype and get them tested and QA'd. We'll be looking at this to give you more potential control and address some of the concerns you've raised. So a lot of people didn't like the obsidian flesh change. Most people were like PvE raid minded with it. One thing that I kind of thought is, you know, they are nerfing the kind of side nodey Condi Weaver really quite hard with that obsidian flesh change. Like, a big part of playing that is like getting your pyro vortex out or something while in Vuln, and you can't now. So, well, not necessarily pyro vortex, because, you know, the number of attunement swaps. But you get what I mean. There's this idea of counter pressuring. And so I guess lots of people talked about that, and that's not going to be making in.
So he says he has some prototypes he wants to work on, but they can't get them tested before the patch. So how quickly is the patch coming then?
Well, I don't think they've given us an exact date yet, have they? Down here, by the way, they do say, and this is the first time we've ever heard this, you know how they won't fully split stuff because core functionality can't change? He does define what core functionality means now, which is cast time, missile velocity, range, radius, and pulse intervals. Which, if you think about it, Boots, that's all stuff that's kind of tied to animation stuff.
Yeah. Right, so they don't want to mess with the animations.
Exactly, yeah. Because, and probably...
because that's a lot more work.
Yeah, exactly. A lot more work. Like, SFX is obviously a big thing. Over on page 2, yeah, he talks about some other stuff.
Also down here, responding to a question about the toughness becoming vitality, they asked if it's possible to change the toughness component that we're missing into armor instead.
I think that's, that's a cool idea, isn't it? To put it into armor. If people aren't aware, obviously the amount of damage you shrug off is a combination of your toughness and the armor stat you're getting from your armor, right?
I thought they meant put it into like your armor pieces as additional toughness stats.
No, I think he means actually add it to the armor attribute, right? Which is kind of cool.
That's a great idea.
When the game came out, you could actually mouse over it and see how they combined or whatever. It's like armor plus toughness equals defense is what it used to be or something.
Yeah, exactly. Well, that's basically what it is. It's the damage someone does, and then it's divided by your armor plus your toughness, essentially.
Yeah, so I like the idea, but I guess Irenio says they can't do that. They just don't have
that's
the tech
so
to do it.
That's so weird. So what is it about that armor stat?
I don't know. It's weird, though. It's almost like, if I think about the idea of toughness tanking in the first place, I almost think it should be like armor tanking in a way, almost, right? I mean, yeah. then you get into a weird space where it's like only the heavy armor classes can do it.
Seven,
right?
Okay, 7 years into Guild Wars 2, almost 8 now, it's like, at the beginning of the game, I thought that being a medium versus a light, versus a heavy armor character really made a huge difference, but then 7 years later, you're just like, oh yeah, they are different armor classes because you get actual armor from them.
Right,
but...
yeah. I think shields, don't shields in Guild Wars 2 still give armor as well? Isn't that true? In Guild Wars 1, it was
maybe.
Definitely true. I can't remember. Do you still get a defense stat from shields?
I don't think so.
Do I have one on my character here to look at? Oh, I don't. Damn. Well, someone in the comments can fill us in on that. And that's it, I guess, then. So that's really the extra stuff about global. So that we don't dawdle too much, let's move now on to the World versus World and PvP-specific stuff. If you guys aren't interested in that, I totally understand. But there you go. That's the global stuff. Boots, which
I'd
one do you want to do?
I actually prefer to dawdle a little bit.
Which one do you want to dawdle our way onto first, then?
Let's go to World versus World.
Okay, so World versus World. So this is from CMC. Hi everyone, we wanted to swing by with an update on the balance patch to respond to some of the main feedback points we've seen. At this point, we're mostly locked down for the release, but we're still gathering. Stability. The biggest point of feedback we've seen on the World vs. World side of things is the concern about longer cooldowns on stability skills and the effect it will have on large-scale engagements. Based on that feedback, we won't be applying most of these changes in World vs. World for the initial update.
Well, the thing is,
it's like, you know, fear bombs and choke points spamming, you know, stack fields and stuff like that down is like really huge in World versus World. You rip through a lot of stuff, and they were killing a lot of the stuff. Stability is still something we want to keep an eye on, but we want to see how everything adjusts before making larger changes.
Yeah, okay, that's fair. That's very fair.
So they're rolling back the idea on all of these stab skills. You guys can pause the video if you want to stop and have a look at those. But yeah, they're generally stab granting things. Stand your ground is still 5 targets. Bringing the 10 target skills back down to 5 is something we want to do across the game outside of PvE. Though for this update, we weren't able to address target cap increases granted by traits. The change was made to Stand Savant was an exceptional case, not a true split, but we felt it was a necessary change to address the fact the impact that Scourge was having on World versus World. Our plan moving forward is that target cap increases granted by traits will be rolled in baseline for PvE, which will then allow us to split the number of targets on an individual skill level instead of removing trait functionality. So the Stand Your Ground halving the number of targets is really big.
It is. It's half as powerful now.
Yeah, that's still a lot, especially as far as World versus World is concerned, but all the personal stabs are going down, I guess. Oh, or coming back, let me put it that way. He also, do you want to read his general balance concerns?
Sure. We've read all the feedback and seen the concerns about future metas and the viability of certain professions and specializations after the update. After the patch goes out, we'll be continuing to iterate as we gather more data and feedback based on actual gameplay.
Right,
we're prepared to act quickly... Sorry, say that again.
That's a whole lot of ways to say nothing, pretty much.
Yeah. it kind of makes me wonder how in-depth their testing is in studio, you know?
Yeah, me too.
We're prepared to act quickly in response to anything egregious that pops up, whether it's an individual build greatly overperforming or a heavy skew of the meta in any particular fashion, unkillable tanks, dominant condition builds. So yeah, this is very much what a lot of the response has been to those particular things, pushing out any power builds, etc. Once any major wrinkles are ironed out, we'll settle back into the faster cadence that we mentioned previously as we work towards improving balance across the board.
Right, okay. Additional changes, minus the previously mentioned stab skills. Concealing restoration, they've reduced the stealth duration from 2 to 1. This is the new Shadow Arts gain stealth on heal skill, which was a huge part of the Shadow Arts rework. Right? I'm pretty sure that's the one. And
I feel like it's always been on heal, no?
No. Shadow Arts added that. The Shadow Arts revamp added stealth on heal. I'm sure it did.
You know what? You're right.
You've obviously got the heal skill itself, Hide in Shadows, that does that, but yeah.
Right. But you've always had stealth on steel. It was heal that was added, right?
Yeah, and that was huge. Like, stealthing at the end of a withdrawal. So they're half that. That was a big thing. We talked about that, personally. In fact, look at this. There's actually... Oh, my God. It's all, like... thiefy oriented. Rending Shade, so when you hit someone with, for out of stealth with a, an ambush, I think it was, you steal boons. They've halved the boons. Assassin Signet is still just as potent as ever, but it's got a longer cooldown, so you can do it less regularly. Okay. Leeching Venoms. Oh, wow, that's really big as well.
Yeah, that's an odd one. Were people really abusing
Venoms? Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. Even I spent like 3 weeks running around on a really gimmicky Deadeye one-shot that utilized the Leeching Venoms. But yeah, Shadow Arts DP was really big, and this was a part of it, honestly. Oh my god, so that's gone from 6 to 2, the number of stacks you power up from that. Wow. Does that even still feel like a fun trait when it goes down to 2?
I guess it means that you'll get your max stacks when you're invisible for the like the ones... You don't have to stack it staying invisible. Just one iteration of stealth will get you your max stacks.
Yeah, you do still get the first stack instantly as well, right? If I remember right.
Yeah, so in 3 seconds of stealth, you'll get both stacks.
Yeah, to be honest, that probably looks like more on... You're right, it looks like more on paper than it probably would in practice. Malicious Backstab had the coefficient go from 2.4 to 1.8, so it goes down. Malicious Backstab being one of the only ones that was still listed at over 2 before. Smokescreen cooldown's gone up. Smokescreen got very, very powerful when it became a big ring, especially in World versus World, where it's great against like anti-projectile. You know, you're getting pew-pew-pewed so much in World versus World. So up to
it's a very, very strong skill.
Yeah, and then lightning rods—they're actually dropping that down a bit more. I remember we actually noted that lightning rods didn't get nerfed as hard as some of the other stuff.
Yeah, but it...
And what, never forget, this is...
Rod, it wasn't even at the 2.0, and it can't crit.
Nah, man, this is really strong. In World versus
it is,
World...
It is really strong, but I wonder if this is because it's trying to bring in line more with the fact that all CCs do 0 damage now, but...
But that's a Grandmaster themed around making CCs do damage.
Exactly, so and it doesn't add additional CCs.
Yeah, I think it's just... Specifically because it's here in World versus World, where putting a static field down in a choke in an environment with like way less personal stab on people, that could have been too strong. So they've tuned it down a little bit.
You think the Leeching Venom change is so that it discourages people from stacking up lots and lots of stealth in combat and just remaining in like perma-stealthing around people?
I don't understand how changing Leeching Venoms actually...
Well, it won't, like, it'll... If people have been looking at Leech and Venom and thinking, okay, I should stay in stealth for 10 seconds rather than 3 seconds, now they'll just be like, okay, I only need 3 seconds and then I could come out of stealth now.
Oh, I see. Maybe, yeah, maybe it affected some people's mindsets who are trying to get, like, really big impact. I tend to feel, though, that when you play a build, you realize what is actually worthwhile. Like, that's such a big tempo loss that if you're losing all your fights anyway, I doubt people were trying to squeeze out all that synergy for no reason if it's losing in the fight, you know? So I don't know whether that was necessarily a big part of the playstyle. But you do tend to linger in stealth a bit more in World versus World, you know?
You do.
Or just sprint
there
away.
There are a lot of perma-stealth thieves roaming out there.
I find this amazing boots as well. Check it out. We've seen feedback around the dragon banner. And we're looking at some slight tweaks on the damage there. We'll be keeping a close eye on siege damage and banner effectiveness related to player skills, and we'll make further adjustments. As a World versus World loser, I honestly don't know how much people do the banners. Is Dragon Banner really...
I feel
really...
the banner had an update to reduce its effectiveness a while ago, because before that it was insane.
Right.
So people do it, I think, less than before, but still they use it. And I wonder if it will be overpowered after this patch if everything else is nerfed and it's not touched.
Yeah, I guess that's a good point. Yeah, actually, I love the idea of them. Do people use Centaur Banner and Turtle Banner a lot?
I don't know.
Well, people in the comments can really fill me in on that. I'd love to see. We get no additional posts on this one, it looks like, guys. So there you go. That's your World versus World section. Lastly, we've got PvP.
Hi, everyone. We wanted to swing by with an update of the balance patch and respond to some of the main feedback points that we've seen. At this point, we're mostly locked down for the release, but we're gathering feedback and continuing some investigation for future work. 0.01. There's been a lot of discussion around CC skills and if all of them should deal minimum damage.
Right, we talked about that, like with warrior physical skills in particular, right?
We did, yeah. We agree that it shouldn't be a hard rule, and there's room for some exceptions. We won't be making any adjustments to these for the initial update, but we expect some changes as we continue to evaluate things moving forward. Even for the exceptions, hard CC skills still won't be near the top of the damage range, but there's room to work with above the 0.01.
Oh, I see. That's why they're saying 0.01. I thought that was some kind of like version change 0.01 to our new vision for balance. I gotcha. All right, all right. Yeah. I was going
to
say.
In some cases, it may make more sense for a skill to not have any CC and instead deal higher damage. This is true. But these would need to be game-wide changes and something that we'll be discussing with the skills team.
Yeah, like I was thinking about Shroud 5 Reaper and whether maybe if it's not doing any damage anymore, they could bring it up to being 3 targets or 5 targets and just instead of just single target. Like the field affects lots of targets, so why not have the impact do that now? Because some of these are such big telegraphed animations, you know.
I feel like Headbutt needs to be reworked a little bit.
Oh, for sure, with the whole double damage when you rip stab off yourself on a 0.01 and stuff like that.
Yeah.
All right, general balance concerns. We've read all the feedback and seen the concerns about future metas and the visibility of certain professions and specializations after the update. After the patch goes out, we'll be continuing to iterate. We're prepared to act more quickly in response to anything agreed. We already read this pretty much. They're just saying, "Don't worry, guys. If it's not good, we'll be careful.
We'll fix it in post. We'll fix it in post." Yeah.
Oh my god, this is really short. I thought the PvP section would be huge, Boots.
No, it's not.
Oh, it's the same thing. It's the thief stuff.
Yeah.
Oh, so the whole lightning rod thing I said could just be BS because it's not really. You know, this isn't world versus world. They're doing the same thing. I actually had to look up to see that we're in the PvP section. Wow, is there any other post? There's nothing different there, is there, Boots? Can you see up at the top?
No. Except for they removed the lightning rod stuff and put in the 0.01 stuff.
Wait, they didn't remove the lightning rod stuff, did they? Are you joking?
The world versus world is the lightning rod stuff.
Yeah, isn't lightning rod on the PvP bit as well? I swear not I just saw mine. It there.
Not in mine.
Really? Okay, hold
what
on.
What are you reading?
Well, I'm on the PvP post. Sorry, I was just scrolling through the other pages. People can see me furiously scrolling through to see if there was any other update. Yeah, dude, I'm on PvP balance update. It says lightning rod.
Okay, remove all of that.
My God, no, I'm not removing it.
Why?
Well, because look, for once we have done a short enough video here that we
can just add in.
We can leave in all this waffle that I'm always editing out.
I haven't had my coffee yet.
He was just trolling me, guys. That's all he was doing.
No, we're removing that. And if it's in the video, I am never doing a video
this,
with you.
Look,
again.
You asked for a thing off the end slate. Here it is. This is it. All right.
No, we have to sing.
So they,
we have to sing
we're
a happy,
not singing. There you go, guys. Thanks very
merry
much.
A song. Come on.
Let us know. Let us know on those little points of intrigue that we didn't know about before, and we'll be back for another balance update if the devs do one. Hopefully it's, substantive. So until then, we're just waiting for a release date. Thank you, everybody.
I have a feeling there's not going to be another update before the patch.
Yeah, maybe not. If this one was as short as it seems to be. It seems to be just like they're sick of the people crying. It's the apocalypse. Basically, it's like some of these sentences, some of these paragraphs are just dedicated to reminding people that life goes on even if a patch isn't perfect.
Yeah, it's like all of these are basically saying, look, okay, you're probably right, but there's nothing we could do about it now. Wait and see what happens, and then we'll fix it.
It's crazy. It's crazy how like one-dimensional people can be on the internet. That's it. Thank you, guys. Hope you enjoyed. It's been great having a chat with you, Boots. I'll see you next time.
Bye-bye.